and it can be killed so that you bear no fruit just by getting occupied with material things. And you see, what's coming down now for the kids, and Satan knows what he's doing, is all these improvements on cell phones and iPods and the rest of it. So Satan can channel his values through there. The kids are fascinated with the toys. It can kill the kingdom. Because that's what's on your mind all the time. It can kill the kingdom. That's what the Bible says. I'm preaching about the difference between heaven and the kingdom. Okay, heaven's a place. I've never been there. I hope to go there soon. We've never been there, so we don't know what to expect. But we do know what's going on today, and we do know there's one novelty after another to keep people's minds off Jesus. Good preaching, Brother Thompson. Yeah. Here we go. I've got to congratulate myself here if nobody else does, all right? Now, still other seed fell on good soil. Now, what does that mean? See, we've been taught so long that no one is righteous and no one is worthy and all, which is a perversion of the Old Testament. It's not true. The Old Testament talked about righteous people in many places. You'll never bear lasting fruit for Christ unless you basically are a good person. Come on. You say, how about some wicked person that killed his grandmother for the insurance and all? Can he be saved? There's people that do terrible things, but in their heart they're a good person. Yeah? Think about King David. Now, King David was a man after God's own heart. God loved David. He looked on his heart. Says, God looks on the inner man. He had a righteous, honorable man murdered. And the man wasn't even an Israelite. He was Uriah. He was a Hittite and one of the 30 mighty men. And David had this man murdered. Not only that, but he committed adultery with the man's wife. Murder and adultery. Two heavies. And you say, David was a wicked man. No, David was not a wicked man. He was a deceived man. He was supposed to go out to war. He was supposed to go out with Joab and the rest of them. And he didn't. He's fooling around in his palace, looks over, sees Bathsheba, and a spirit of Satan and deception entered him. And he committed two terrible sins. Well, his prophet Nathan came to him and told him what he'd done. And David said, oh boy, whoa. And Nathan said to him immediately two things, and I want you to get this in your heart. The first thing he said was, God has caused your sin to pass away. And he said, you're going to be punished. And David was punished royally. It was after that that Absalom rebelled against him. And it was after that that God led him into temptation and he numbered the people. But David died in honor. And the child born between David and Bathsheba was Solomon, who built the temple of God to show the tremendous way in which God deals with people. Now, you might say from a thing like that, well, if I sin, God will cause my sin to pass away. You don't know that it will. David was a man after God's heart. Jesus refers himself the son of David. This is David this, David that, and David the next thing. And his psalms have blessed mankind ever since he died. And yet, he sinned as bad as a man can sin. What does that teach us? That we're free to sin? No, it does not teach us that. Because, you see, David did not get up in the morning and say, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to commit adultery and murder somebody. He didn't do that. He was caught. He was not out to battle like he should have been. He was not poised. the way he should have been, and he was deceived. But God saw that he was a righteous man. And that's what I meant by saying there are people who murdered their grandmother for the insurance. Then a chaplain comes through death row. The man said, oh man, I'm a sinner, I repent. God saw that his heart was righteous all the time. And people are complex. That's why it's good never to judge anybody. Don't go pulling up your pride and saying, you know what he did. Because you may be next on the list. Salvation is of the Lord. If we didn't make mistakes and do things wrong, we wouldn't need a redeemer. So we do things wrong. But if we don't have an honest and good heart, we'll never make it as a Christian. We have to be inside, basically, an honest, good. That's why it says it fell on good ground. Where am I? It fell on good ground, somewhere on here, and it produced a crop, and it differed from person to person. Do you see that? But I want you to notice that good heart, because the religion, our religion, has fallen on hard times. There is more scurrilous things that are done by Christians because they never had a righteous heart to begin with, and they're trying to prove God loves them and he saves them by grace and everything else. And there's people in the world that have never accepted Christ and that have an honest and good heart. We need to be careful that our religion doesn't get in the way of what's right and what's wrong. Okay, that's enough of that. I was glad when they said unto
me, let us go unto the house of the Lord. If you would like to know more about Dr. Robert Thompson or Mount Zion Fellowship, please write to us at P.O. Box 1522, Escondido, California 92033, or give us a call at area code 760-747-8325. Visit us on the web at www.wor.org. Join us again next week for another program of the Word of Righteousness with Dr. Robert Thompson.